afternoon, fans.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this AUS Women's Soccer telecast brought to you by the St. FX Varsity Club here at Oland Stadium, featuring the host team, the St. FX X-Women, and the visiting Dalhousie Tigers. Good afternoon from Andy Ganesh. I'm Corey LeBlanc, joined by fourth-year St. FX nursing student Marcy Kennedy. Welcome, Marcy, our first time together.
Yeah, how are you, Corey? Good. Excited today?
Excited, the first regular season varsity match of the season on home turf for the X-Women, coming off last season's quarterfinal loss to the St. Mary's University Huskies, and of course facing the Dal Tigers, the defending champions, who were really somewhat a surprise last year, winning the AUS title, but this season are looking like favorites and have gotten off to a good start, particularly with last week's win over the X-Women in Halifax. From all accounts, a really dominant performance over the X-Women in a 3-1 win.
We're definitely in for an exciting game today, Corey. And, of course, it's a beautiful day for soccer. So there's lots of fans in the stands watching.
Yeah, a great crowd here at Oland Stadium, and we certainly welcome everyone with us on the worldwide web watching, of course, all ex-graduates, friends and family of the players, and we hope you can send us along an email letting us know how we're doing. Marcy and I, it's our first time together, so it's a bit of a feeling out process, but we'll let the action speak for itself and fill in the blanks for you throughout the match. And of course, this is the first half of a doubleheader coming up after this one. It's the X-Men versus the Tigers in a rematch of last week's home opener for the Tigers, that the X-Men come out on top with a big 1-0 win with the shutout by Andrew McDonald, the fourth year senior from Andy Ganesh. So the X-Men trying to get in the win column. Most of the team returning, some key losses, but they do have Olivia Zanetti and Laura Woodman back up front, Marcy, and that's going to be a key to get them on track and find the back of that net.
It'll be really interesting to watch those girls tonight.
And for the Tigers, of course, well-balanced under the tutelage of Jack Hutchinson. Again, the AUS defending champions looking to make a 2-in-a-row over the X-Women here to start the season. So some of the key returnees for the X-Women, as we hear the starting lineups for each team in the background. Again, Olivia Zanetti and Laura Woodman back. And, of course, Maris Miller in her fourth season. Actually, third season, Maris Miller. She's going to be a key as well this year after Anna Thompson finished her fifth year. So now the starting nod goes to Miller. And she played well last year when Thompson was hurt.
It'll be interesting to see how the X-Women fare this year.
And then we hear in the background the introduction, the veteran Megan Ramsden, a backline player, really a key for the X-Women that keeps everything running smoothly from there. So the X-Women, again, under head coach Trevor Reddick in his 10th season, joined again by Quentin Partridge, the goaltending coach, back with him for another season, both Andy Ganesh products and Andy Ganesh from the Andy Ganesh minor system, so a local flavor there. And of course, Trevor Reddick, a former national champion at the senior level, and was a member of, if I remember correctly, the last X-Men team to make an appearance at Nationals.
Yeah, and of course, this broadcast wouldn't be brought to you without the sponsors. And this one's brought to you by the X-Women webcast, by the X-Varsity Club. Join the team behind the teams. The X-Varsity Club is a fundraising entity for the St. FX Athletic Program. Your financial support is essential for our success in maintaining the tradition of excellence. Visit www.goxgo.ca for more information on the X-Varsity Club.
And now we'll pause for a moment as we hear the national anthem before we start the match.
Keep our
We're back. Great rendition of O Canada there. The team shaking up before the match, as it is tradition in soccer, the shaking of the hands before we get started. I'm just going to run quickly, Marcy, through the starting lineup for both teams. For the Tigers, number 2, Samantha McDonald. Number 7, Stephanie Crew. Number 9, Emma Landry. Number 11, Joanna Blodgett. Number 13, Elise Bilodeau. Number 14, Daphne Wallace. Number 15, Bianca Jakiza. Number 18, Megan Willocks. Number 19, Rieka Santilli. Number 23, Christy McGregor-Bales. And the keepers, number 24, Taryn McKenna. And for the home side, the ex-women, number 23, Bobby Martin on the back end. Number 20, Victoria Penner. Number 16, Gabby Berg. Number 12, Nicole McNeil. Number 11, Rachel Dragon. A striker, number 8, Olivia Zanetti. Number 6, a wing midfield, Mallory McDonnell. Again, the veteran Megan Ramsden, her fourth year from Ottawa. Number 4, the hometown product from Dr. John McGillis Regional. Number 3, Stephanie Venadam. And then again, another wing midfield, number 2, Stephanie Cameron. And as we mentioned, between the pipes, the St. John's Newfoundland native in her third year, number 1, Maris Miller. So we're about ready to get rolling. The first varsity match of the season at Oland Stadium. Start of a busy weekend here. Of course, the men coming up after this, and then the home opener for the X-Men football team against Concordia tomorrow afternoon. Now we're underway.
It's pretty exciting here. Kickoff just started.
Handling ball there. Rachel Dragon looking for some room. The Tigers take over, and it's chipped by Samantha McDonald. Battle for control there. Dal takes it. Chipped ahead. Looks into the box. Maris Miller's going to handle it easily.
She was on top of that.
So a quick start there. Dal putting a little bit of pressure on Marcy, but nothing too dangerous. And now we're back in the midfield. A battle there for possession. Coming up with it there, the Tigers. But there's a turnover. And now the X-Men control, and it's Stephanie Cameron. Cameron turns away from her defender, puts it back to Victoria Penner, who puts it out the touch, so it'll be a throw-in for the Tigers. Inbound play, controlled by the Tigers. Now a battle for it. Two X-Women against a Tiger opponent. Now coming down the side, far side on your screen. Now the Tigers putting some pressure on. There's a battle for the ball there between Gabby Berg and number 13, Elise Bilodeau. So it looks like we're going to have a first opportunity of the match. A corner kick for the Tigers. And it's going to be Joanna Blodgett, Marcy, taking it. So what will you look for here? Now some jockeying for position.
Yeah, we have some great setup in the net here. The girls definitely fighting for some positions there.
Tigers get ahead on it, but it's an easy save for Miller. Now Miller gives it a couple of bounces. She puts a boot on it. Looking up ahead there for Rachel Dragon. Dragon can't control.
And it's out.
And now a quick throw in by the Tigers. Ramson's going to take it off the bounce. Now on that possession, number 14, Daphne Wallace skies. And now she's in a battle with Gabby Berg. Berg changes the side of the field to Venadam. Venadam tries to put it through the middle, but that's intercepted. Venadam takes it again, but loses it. And now the Tigers look to mount some attack. Coming in there, Elise Bilodeau. Bilodeau puts it across, but that's cleared easily. It looks by number 12 for the X-Women. That's Nicole McNeil. So a little back and forth here early on, Marcy, but no real opportunities other than the Dal header off the cross, or off the corner kick, rather. Now Ramsden takes it from her Tiger opponent. Now number 15 for the Tigers, Bianca Jakiza. She puts it back, and that shot from the back line goes wide.
X-Women's Soccer and St. Evax Athletic would like to thank our major sponsors for their continued support. Pepsi, Labatt's, Tim Hortons, the Bergen Credit Union, Subway, Central Home Improvement, and Highcrest Enterprise. And a thank you to our media sponsors, 98.9 XFM, The Casket, and 101.5 The Hawk.
Now it's Rieka Santilli for the Tigers, one of the big sharpshooters for their team, who scored in last week's match against the X-Women, which again opened the season. They defeated the X-Women at Wickwire Field in Halifax 3-1. Now battle for it at the midfield. Daphne Wallace tries to make a move. It comes back to her teammate Stephanie Crew. Crew puts it over to Santilli.
They're making some great passes out here.
Starting to string some together, but the X-Women take over. Now Ramsden can't catch up to it, so it's out the touch, and the Tigers will have a throw-in. Looks like Christy McGregor-Bales is going to take it. Tries to put it into Daphne Wallace. Now Wallace can't control, but comes up with it again. Puts it ahead, but it's McNeil. McNeil puts it over to Venedem. Venedem loses control, and now again the Tigers. A lot of jockeying for position in the midfield here early on. We're scoreless, about 4.5 minutes unofficially. Now the Tigers in across.
Oh.
Sliding attempt that goes just wide. So Dell with a golden opportunity there was Emma Landry. I'm not sure who got the foot on it on the pass across the box, but it went just wide. I think it may have been a number 11, Joanna Blodgett.
Definitely a close one for Miller. I'm sure her heart rate got up to speed there.
And Miller tees it up, so to speak, to take the goal kick. Again, unofficially by, of course, it's by the official's watch, not the scoreboard, but we are about 5 minutes into the opening half here on opening day of the St. of XX Women's home season in the AUS Women's Soccer League. They're scoreless with the visiting and defending AUS champion, Dal Tigers. Again, thanks for joining us on this X-Varsity Club webcast of St. of XX Women Soccer. I'm Corey LeBlanc along with Marcy Kennedy. So early on, a couple of chances for the Tigers. The X-Women haven't made it down really into the Tigers' end thus far.
Yeah, it's going pretty good so far for both teams. They're definitely putting on a good fight out there.
And now it's going to be a throw-in. Gabby Berg, the second-year defender from Calgary, Alberta. There's been a pretty good pipeline in recent years in Trevor Reddick's tenure of getting some Western players coming east here to St. FX. And of course, now the same with the X-Men as well, with a few players coming along that have played for Graham Kennedy or know Graham Kennedy, the Andy Ganish native and now head coach of the X-Men that coached in Calgary, the Foothills Club, for many years. So now the X-Women on a throw-in. Venedem controls. She keeps it along the side. Good feet there by Venedem to keep it under control, but then she's called for the foul. That was an obvious one. She put the grab on her Tigers opponent to try to get possession.
And for all you fans, make sure you stay in touch with St. of X Athletics throughout the season. Become a fan on our Facebook page or follow us on Twitter for the latest scores and news.
Now again in the X-Women and Penner. Chips it to Venedem. Can Venedem keep it in? She does. Tries to put it up there to Woodman, or Stephanie Cameron, rather, but that doesn't work. So, again, much of the play early on, the first 7 minutes or so, has been in the X-Women end. There hasn't been much penetration by the X-Women into the Tiger zone. As you can see, the keeper for the Tigers is out about the 30-yard line, Taryn McKenna. And now the X-Men trying to change the field, but that was a good play by the Tigers to cut that pass attempt off as the cross was looking for Dragon. So a play there by Rieka Santilli, again one of the key members of the Tigers. And again, the Tigers looking to pen the X-Women in their own end. Battle for possession here. And along the sidelines, Dragon trying to make a run, but she's cut off by Santilli. Santilli off to a strong start here for the Tigers. There's about a little forearm in the back there that wasn't called. Joanna Blodgett got away with one there, it looked like. And now the Tigers look to attack. Emma Landry making a little run on McNeil. Miller has to make a save, and then she collides.
That was close, but she had it.
Miller showed good hands. She bobbled it a touch. But again, Emma Landry got a good foot on that ball. She made her way. She got by McNeil. and got a good shot away. Now it's Ramsden. Ramsden battling against Emma Landry. She puts it back to Miller. Miller shanks one, and it goes to Landry. So that was a dangerous play there. Miller definitely didn't get enough of the toe on that one, but luckily it went off of Landry and out for a goal kick for Maris Miller. So far, Marcia, again, a couple of big chances for the Tigers as we get almost 9 minutes in. The X-Men need to start mounting some offense and get it out of their end.
Yeah, we'd definitely love to see some offense on the part of the X-Women here.
Another throw-in for the Tigers. Again, quite a few throw-ins thus far. A little stops and starts and spurts here early on a gorgeous evening here in Antigonish. It was really unseasonably warm up in the mid to high 20s here, almost a beach day. And for mid-September in northeastern Nova Scotia, that's a rarity.
I think it was 26 at one point today, Chris. It's definitely a beautiful day.
And the wind isn't a big factor here at Oland Stadium. It's blowing a little bit maybe from the near side, the stands, across the field. But again, it doesn't seem like it's going to be much of a factor here. So we have the X-Women in white going from left to right on your screen. The Tigers now with control of the ball, right to left in their signature row black and gold uniforms. And now it's Santilli. A little bit of room there. Now, nice ball to Landry. She's onside, but a nice play there by Gabby Berg, who puts the body on Emma Landry, who was almost in alone, and Miller's able to smother it.
Great save by the X-Women.
And Gabby Berg has been busy today. The second-year defender from Calgary, and that was a great play there. She used her strength against Landry, the smaller player, and knocked her off the ball and allowed Miller to smother it. Again, the X-Women trying to mount something here, but I don't know if we've called either Zanetti's name at all thus far, because the ball just hasn't made its way up to the strikers. And again, the Tigers not giving the X-Women much room to maneuver here. And now the Tigers look to counterattack. That's Christy McGregor Bales puts it ahead along the far sidelines. And now the X-Women. Here comes Victoria Penner with some room. She takes her space, puts the left foot on it. And that's the first save of the afternoon for Tara McKenna. An easy one when you're a goalkeeper. That's a nice one to get started with. Get a feel for the ball, Marcy, and nothing too dangerous.
Yeah, definitely a great save there.
Now with the left foot, it was Venedan trying to put it ahead. And now there's a little turn there. Nifty little move by Elise Bilodeau, bodying it by her defender. Now with the left foot.
Just far of the net.
Was Landry, who's been dangerous thus far, and she puts it wide. Another goal kick for the X-Women. So Miller's been busy thus far. We're about 11 and a half minutes into the opening half. We're scoreless. The Dalhousie Tigers and the St. FX X-Women in AUS Women's soccer action here, brought to you by the X-Varsity Club. Thank you for joining us on this webcast, and hopefully you're enjoying the match thus far. And don't forget to stay tuned, because it's the first half of a doubleheader with the X-Men and the Tigers men's team ready for the opening kick at about 7:15.
And there's plenty of fans out today watching the game. It's such a beautiful day. What better time to come see some soccer, right?
Bianca Jaquiza tries to cross it, but that goes off Ramsden. But we'll have a corner kick, the second one of the match for the Tigers. So again, early on, a couple of big chances for the Tigers. I don't think Trevor Reddick's seated on the bench with his chin in his hand. I think he might be a little frustrated thus far, because really, the X-Women have mounted no offensive attack, and the Tigers have kept it in their end quite handily.
It's definitely been a very one-sided game so far. Hopefully, the X-Women can turn it around and take the home opener.
So, again, that's always good to have when you start off a little slowly, to have a veteran like Miller on the back line that's steady and doesn't panic as their team. And with the home opener too, sometimes there's a little bit of jitters, and with the home crowd and the excitement of the first game. So we'll see if the X-Women start to shake the cobwebs a little bit here as we go along. So this is probably the deepest We've seen it in the Tigers' end. Ramsden. She and Landry go up and they battle again. Ramsden with the left foot.
The X-Men women are trying their hardest to keep it up there.
Now again, trying to put some passing together. It's just not working right now. And now the Tigers, but Ramsden coolly puts it ahead. Venedam. She attacks her opponent, but the Tigers maintain control. Now ball. Miller's going to make a long run to see if she can put it out to touch, and she does. It'll be a throw-in for the Tigers. So again, the Tigers don't like being in their own end very much because they barely quickly turned it, and they're back in the X-Women's zone. That was Christy McGregor-Bales who put it out, so it'll be a throw-in. Victoria Penner's going to handle it. About 14 minutes into the opening half, we're scoreless, the X-Women and the Tigers. Berg, it's over her head. Now she's going to battle. Berg comes up with it. Gabby Berg, who's been busy thus far. Now it's Bobby Martin. Shot ahead. Cameron gets ahead on. She skies. The smaller Cameron gets up there against her taller opponent, and now she has control in a real battle there, but loses it against two Tigers. She had no support. Now Landry. Ramsden goes down. Landry, Ramsden, battling for the ball. No whistle yet from Wendell McGibbon, who's handling the middle today.
Dalhousie are really doing a great job keeping it in the St. Evex zone right now.
Berg has to chip it out with the head. And now Dal again. The dangerous part of this for the X-Women is when all the plays in your end, eventually something has to give and a crack comes in the armor and you have the opening goal against you.
Hopefully Miller can hold it out in the net today.
Now with the throw in, the Tigers. Santilli looks for Landry. Landry along the side, battling against McNeil. Oh, little tug there. McGibbon lets it go. Looking to change the field, but Miller's going to gobble it up. So Miller's been busy early on, about 16 minutes in. We're still scoreless here in AUS Women's Soccer. This is the rematch of opening night last Friday where the Tigers defeated the X-Women 3-1. The Tigers, the defending league champions, looking to up their record to 2-0, and the X-Women trying to break the goose egg early on in this season. Nifty little move there and a shot just wide. Bianca Chiquiza showed some nifty footwork, but she couldn't hit the target, and Miller lets it sail wide, and she'll have a goal kick. So a nifty move there by Chiquiza, Marcy.
Yeah, it was a great move there. Luckily, Miller was on top of it.
Miller's getting a workout early on with that right leg. We're going to have a substitution, actually, for the Tigers. Lauren Landry looks like number 4. He's going to enter the game for number 13, Elise Bilodeau. So it's actually Elise by the roster, a midfielder, checking in for the striker, Bilodeau. Landry gets up there. Chipped ahead. Chiquiza now, who just had a great opportunity from the middle top of the box. Santilli. Santilli gets the right foot on it, and that's going to go wide. So again, the Tigers sustaining that pressure. No, maybe one or two quality scoring chances, but nevertheless, the play's been on your TV or your computer screen. It's been all to the left so far into the X-Women's zone.
Miller changing up there, kicking from the other side of the box.
Comes right back to Miller. She gives it a bounce. Puts the boot on it. Now it's Ramsden showing some speed. Now Ramsden trying to get something moving for the X-Women. Cameron pressures her opponent and it goes out of bounds, but it's off the X-Women and it'll be a throw-in for the Tigers. Lauren Landry, who just subbed in. The X throw in. Venedim along the far side. She'll have a throw in. So the X-Women trying to put something together here in the Tigers' end. Give Taryn McKenna a test there, the keeper for the Tigers, who's been the least busy player on the field thus far. Now again, it's Chiquiza. She tries to make a move.
McNeil got it out of there.
Now Santilli. Santilli, McNeil, and Chiquiza get tangled up. Now it's Santilli in a right shot. Big save by Miller. The rebound
just
over
wide.
The bar. So Joanna Blodgett with a glorious opportunity on the rebound after Miller made a fabulous save on Santilli. So Santilli showed there, along with Blodgett, why they were league all-stars last year. But Miller with the save of the match thus far.
That was definitely a great save by Maris Miller. And, I mean, for a goalie, it's very stressful to have that many players in your box that consistently.
Now it's Dragon with the left foot. Just as we approach 20 minutes unofficially in the first half, we're scoreless. But again, Maris Miller, the third year from St. John's.
Emma Landry with the ball here, approaching the Saint-Evax net.
Landry gets picked, tripped up. Now Dragon. Whistle blows. So it's going to be X-Women off the handball and Ramston. It's going to look to tee it up. So again, the X-Women just not finding the formula thus far. A lot of play in their own end. Not stringing anything together. Now Penner looking to get something started.
McNeil with the ball.
Now Ramsden. Berg. There we have number 15. It's looks like Zanetti. She tries to get it with the right foot to Venedim. Now Venedim. Venedim getting hounded by her opponent with the left foot.
Over to Zanetti.
Zanetti. Cameron putting her hand up in the box looking for the ball. Now the shot, that goes wide. It'll be a goal kick for the Tigers. So 21 minutes into the opening half, we're scoreless here at Oland Stadium. St. of X X-Women webcast featuring the X-Women and the visiting Dalhousie Tigers.
And, of course, this is brought to you by the X Varsity Club. Join the team behind the teams. The X Varsity Club is the fundraising entity for the St. of X Athletic Program.
So now the Tigers again.
Emma Landry with the ball again. Saved by Miller.
Maris Miller's been busy.
She's definitely been holding her own this game.
Oh, it's Ramsden. The veteran again, the fourth-year player, another Calgary product. Or I'm sorry, from Ottawa, Ontario. Apologies to Ottawa, the graduate of St. Anthony's High School. We have another substitution here. Actually, it's a repair for some blood. Probably some turf burn there.
Trainer's quickly bandaging her up.
I don't think you'll see Chiquiza off very long. She's been dangerous thus far. She's a third-year striker from Mississauga, Ontario. Now, again, along that far sideline, Venedim in a battle there, along with Penner. The ball comes loose. The Tigers, again, mounting an attack. Great ball there. Looking for Santilli. She gets a floater away that goes wide. So Santilli's been dangerous. So far, she took the ball there, just couldn't get a good boot on it. And now we see Chiquiza back in.
Corner kick for Dalhousie.
They take it short. Santilli. She crosses it in. Dangerous ball there. It's finally cleared. Berg. Now finally some room for Rachel Dragon. Looking to take some space. Brings it to the middle. Now changes the field. Looks for Cameron. Cameron in alone, but Venedam can't corral it to get it to her. And then she kicks it off to Ashley Donnelly, and it'll be a throw-in for the X-Women. So a great opportunity there. It's just Venedam couldn't corral it, Marcy. She had Cameron in alone if she was able to chip it ahead.
Yeah, we had some great ball movement there by the X-Women. Hopefully they can turn it around.
A great idea there by Dragon. She brought it off the near sideline and took it to the middle and changed the field, and that almost sent two X-Women in alone. Really the best pressure of the match so far for St. FX. The crowd still filing in. As you said, Marcy, for a Friday evening not long after work, it's a great crowd here at Oland Stadium. Of course, the weather's been fabulous.
Just and I mean, every time I look down, there's more and more people there. Just keeps filling up, so definitely come check this out if you're in the Anaganish area.
And if you can't, just sit right here with us, and we'll have all the action here for the women's match. And, of course, coming up, the men's match. The X-Men looking to up their record to 2-0 in the early season. The young X-Men, a mix of veteran talent, but they do have a lot of newcomers on the team, and they're off to a good start. Behind the goalkeeping and opening the shutout for Andrew McDonald, the Anaganish product, of course. And now there's a left footer. Miller has to dive. Didn't look too dangerous early on, but then Jakiza. No, I'm sorry. Actually, it was Santilli again. It's just been a force here. Our first team all-star last season. She's certainly showing why, and she's on that back end, really. But she's a dangerous force on the offensive end when she comes up into the play, Marcy. And now she's even going to take the throw in.
And we're 25 minutes into play here on the score clock.
So again, much of the play in the X-Women zone. Certainly not a recipe for success. Hard to score from your own eight, the top of your 18-yard box if all the play is there. And that's the problem right now for the X-Women. So there's a clear by Penner. And now Venedem off the second head there by Holland. Now along the side, Venedem can't control, but it's off a Tiger, and the X-Women will make a throw-in. It'll be Victoria Penner. Dalhousie take over on the turnover off the throw, and a left footer there. Miller corrals it before it goes out. The shot would have been wide, but Miller didn't take any chances, and now she's going to see if she can help her teammates get the attack here midway through the opening half. Good header there by Holland.
The X-Women moving into Tiger territory here.
I'm not sure we have our rosters here, Marcy, but I'm looking, and we're calling, of course, by our roster number 15 as Stacy Holland, but it's at least by my not 2020 eyes, it looks like, especially where she's positioned up front, that it's Olivia Zanetti who often wears number 8, so we'll have to check on that. I think they're
That's Zanetti. Not Stacy Holland.
Yeah, and that's it's Zanetti, and I think I called her Zanetti before, but she's not wearing her signature number 8. I think she's wearing 15 today. And now in for the Tigers, number 17, Jenna Gooby. A striker, 5'3", in her second year from Sackville, Nova Scotia. So now it's Cameron. And again, that is Zanetti. Cameron and Zanetti up front. Now in the middle, it's Landry. Landry, a nifty little pass there, but Crew was knocked off the ball. And Penner makes a couple of great moves, but her pass is errant. Now comes back.
And McNeil's controlling the game right now. What's she going to go with that?
Ramsden with some time. She changes the field.
Ramsden is great for that. She's really good at changing the side of the game here.
Now Venedem. Nice pass to Cameron, but she's knocked off the ball. Venedem supports and picks it up again. Venedem. Dal defender takes over now. Ramsden again pinching up. It's a little back and forth here. Now it's back into the X-Women end. I think Miller's going to let it roll. Pick it up. No, she's going to let it settle. put it off to her teammate now. Berg, that's a dangerous pass. Not much mustard on that one. That gets turned over to the Tigers. And now right in the middle, battle there. Oh, there's a strike there. A high one just over the bar would have been good for a field goal in football. But Daphne Wallace, Miller looked like she was in good position and knew it was sailing. She did her jump, but it sailed over the bar. So again, another golden opportunity for the Tigers here as we get to about 29 minutes into the opening half. We're scoreless here at Oland Stadium. The Dal Tigers and the St. FX X-Women. Again, it's Corey LeBlanc along with Marcy Kennedy. Thanks for joining us on our first X-Varsity Club X-Men or X-Women webcast of the season. So we're glad to be back for another year of exciting X-Men and X-Women sports.
And of course, feel free to send us your feedback on the broadcast. We welcome any comments or messages. We can receive them through email at stfx.webcast@gmail.com.
And whether it's, we'll take it all. We'll take help with name pronunciations. They're always welcome from moms and dads or friends and family. And I think we do have it right now on that being Olivia Zanetti up front wearing 15. We're used to seeing her in 8. And if we have any other boo-boos, certainly drop us an email or a hello to someone. And we'd like to hear from ex-alumni or friends of St. of X or parents. That's what we're here for, to bring you all the action when you can't be here in Antigonish. And now the Tigers, a rare touch here for Tara McKenna. He's not been busy at all, had to make maybe one save thus far, and that ball trickles out. It'll go back to the Tigers. McKenna's going to go over to get it. It's going to be a throw, and it looks like Santilli is going to take it. Nice throw in by Santilli. Ramsden got away with a little forearm in the back there, no call. Thus far, Wendell McGibbons letting them play, Marcy. It's been quite physical here early on.
Yeah, he's not calling a whole lot.
Now it's Cameron going with that lifty left foot. Cameron tries to put it forward. A little too far, Zanetti, and the defender took over and clears it to safety, and Penner lets it sail through, and she'll have a throw in. Looks like we're going to have our first substitution for the X-Men of the match. Dal's made a couple. And we'll see shortly, Marcy, who it is when she takes her pinny off. Now, again, as you said, Ramsden loves to change.
I think that's Sarah Kennell coming into the game.
Yeah, Sarah coming in. Sarah, of course, a veteran of the team, now in her third season, another Ottawa, Ontario product. And Ramsden. Zanetti. She clutch and grab here between Zanetti and Santilli, and now Ramsden. Very physical in the midfield there. As we said, Wendell McGibbons laying them play thus far.
McNeil's on top of it, getting it out for the X-Men.
And now we will see, as you said, Sarah Cannell coming in, number 10. Center midfielder, again, her third season from Ottawa. And she's on for Mallory McDonnell, the Auburn Drive graduate. Just about 32 minutes unofficially into the opening half. Again, we're scoreless. A few chances, more so on the Tigers' side, a couple of corner kicks, and then really a glorious save by Maris Miller off of Rieka Santilli about 10 minutes ago, and that's kept it at goose eggs on the scoreboard here at Oland Stadium. Now it's Cameron with some nifty footwork along the far side looking to get that left foot.
Cameron's been putting a lot of pressure on the Tigers' defense today for the X-Women.
Now in the middle. Dragon can't get loose. Sarah Cannell tries to make a dive and cackle. That doesn't work. Berg now has to get on her horse as she battles in the corner with Jenna Gooby. Gooby puts it across Miller. Oh, and it's an own goal. Miller bobbled it. It looked like a harmless floater, but Miller couldn't hang on. It looked like it went in off of Victoria Penner. So a tough break there, but great hustle again on the initial rush. Gabby Berg got beaten by Gooby, who showed a good burst of speed and then put it across. Miller looked uncertain, took her eye off it a little bit, and then it bounced in off of Victoria Penner. And we have our opening goal about 33 minutes into the opening half. The Tigers strike first blood, and they lead the X-Women 1-0.
And that's just a horrible feeling for a soccer player to score on your own net. I feel really bad for that girl. Hopefully she can turn it around the rest of the game.
And now the X-Women trying to counterattack here. Sarah has it in the middle with some room, looking for Dragon. Dragon tries to settle, but she's covered like a glove by Santilli. Santilli puts it over to Lauren Landry. And now Penner. Penner trying to atone for the misfortunate own goal. Now a shot in, she scores!
And that was a great play for St. Evax. We had lots of nice ball movement there. The girls really came back with a force.
And the X-Women celebrate their first goal.
Tie game here at Oland Stadium.
So the X-Women, a great response there. And it's good to see it started with Victoria Penner, who unfortunately had that own goal bounce in off of her as it went through the hands of Maris Miller. But she helped start the play to get that opening goal for the X-Women.
She certainly redeemed herself with that assist.
And Sarah Cannell making Trevor Reddick look like a genius just shortly, maybe a minute or two after her substitution. She opens the scoring for the X-Women and nodded at one goal apiece.
Definitely came into the game with a bang.
And now for the X-Men into the match, number 14, Alex Brooks. And now for the Tigers coming in, Jenna Gooby coming back in, looks. And then now number 15, Bianca Jakiza is back.
Stepping on the field for the Dalhousie Tigers is...
Actually, Jakiza looked like she was checking in, but or Gooby rather, but she was just actually, that was her position for the start of play after the tying goal. So it's just Jakiza back into the match for the Tigers. We're not at a two, probably a pair of goals less than 2 minutes, probably a minute or so apart. Marcy and now we'll see if that gives the X-Women a little spark. It certainly got the crowd and the team excited. Now Miller.
That was a close one.
That was a dangerous play. She looked like she was preparing for the head, and nobody got any touch on it, and it came to Miller's feet, but she was able to smother it. Now Ramsden looking for Venedan. Venedan to Penner. Again, Penner helped set up that opening X-Women goal. Cannell.
Maris Miller all over that.
One thing about Maris Miller, she's a competitor. I know that first goal was, she has to wipe it away, but I know that'll give her a little extra fire here as the match goes on. She was pretty disappointed in herself that she let that ball slip through her hands. So about almost 36 and a half minutes into the opening half. Again, we're not at that one goal apiece. Probably about 33 minutes in, the Tigers score on an own goal, and then about a minute later, Sarah Cannell finished off a passing play with a nice low left-footed shot that beat Tara McKenna to not the score at one. Santilli's great on the throw-in. She puts it into the box, but it's cleared away by McNeil. Now Penner. There's Zanetti. But the Tigers put it back in. Oh, and there's a nice chip and a goal, but it's an offside. Miller seemed to know it, although she was lucky on that one because that was a great play there by number 9, Emma Landry, but I think there was no doubt on the call that she was offside and no dispute from the Tigers bench or the players.
Very close, though.
But Landry certainly showed some great touch there to take it out of the air. So now Ramsden again, physical with Landry. Ramsden's played a really physical match thus far.
And she's just great at controlling the game. You can see her when she has the ball down there. She knows where to go with it. She knows which way she wants to control the game to go.
Yeah, she said she's very adept at changing the field for the X-Men, and often teams get caught in staying on one side of the field and they forget.
Ramston's a great player to have on the field if you're in that type of game.
Now it's Cameron battling her opponent, Daphne Wallace. The Tigers clear. Ramsden again up in the air with Landry. And now Miller looks like she's going to be able to corral it before Gooby gets it. Miller, not sure what she wants to do. Now puts it ahead, looking for Cameron. Now along the sidelines, it's Dragon. She's in a battle with Santilli. Santilli again with another nice throw and just a little too far for Landry.
McNeil with the save.
See if she can keep it in. She does. Great ball there by McNeil to Cameron, looking to get some offense going, but she's knocked off the ball. Quickly, the back line of the Tigers. On that occasion, Samantha McDonald didn't give Cameron any room to maneuver. Zanetti. Again, Ramsden. And Ramsden, being the smart veteran that she is, she's McGibbons laying the play, and she's being physical. And until they call it, you play the way the referee dictates. And she's being very physical out there, which is nothing new for Megan Ramsden, a great competitor from Ottawa.
And I mean, Dalhousie's a very competitive team. They're quite aggressive on the field. You have to come back at that, right?
Again, Santilli, McDonald. Ramsden tries to control it, a bouncing ball. Now Ramsden battling, and she hauls down. She hard to miss that one. Ramsden wrapped up Joanna Blodgett and pulled her down. So that was an easy call for McGibbon to make. And now the Tigers, just inside the 45, looking to see what they can get off a kick. Nice ball there. Maybe a little too far it was for Landry. Christy McGregor bails just a little too far, but again, the right idea. As we get to just over 40 minutes into the first half, we're tied at one. Again, we open the scoring about 33 minutes in on an old goal by the Tigers. And the X-Men were able to knot it up. Sarah Cannell with her first of the season on a great left-footed shot that beat Tara McKenna. And that's where we tied at one.
And make sure you stay in touch with Sanivax Athletic throughout the season. Become a fan on our Facebook page or follow us on Twitter for all the latest scores and news. Visit www.goxgo.ca to sign up for our weekly newsletter and receive an instant text message on all your X-Men and X-Women team news.
Now in the box, Ramsden clears with the left foot. Gooby had a great chance there, but she couldn't get it through. Now it's Dragon. Dragon with her. Looks again Santilli in hot pursuit. And she takes it from Dragon. And now in the midfield, McDonald puts it ahead. Too far for her teammate. And Ramsden heads it to Dragon. But it's turned over to Landry. An unforced one there. Now the Tigers looking to mount.
Great save by Megan Ramsden there.
Ramsden cleared it and also really forced the offside there by number 15, Bianca Chiquiza. So Megan Ramsden is advertised, the veteran, really the anchor back there for the X-Women, and showing why she's been a league all-star. Big thing with the X-Women in this first half, they've gotten that one goal, and it was on a great passing play, but other than that, they've had trouble stringing together any sort of passes that can get them up the field.
They're visiting the Tiger territory more frequently, though.
Now in the midfield is Cameron. Zanetti trying to break free here, and she's knocked down. And we get a whistle there as McDonald puts the shoulder in the Zanetti, who goes down. Now the X-Women.
And according to our score clock, it's 42-32 here at Oland Stadium.
Ramsden's going to take the kick. We just had one about from the same area by the Tigers that just didn't click on a scoring chance. Ramsden kind of loops one in, but the Tigers headed away. Now they're looking to turn it up the field, and it's Gooby. Gooby puts a foot on it, looking for number 15, Jakisa. And now it's Landry. She puts a move on Ramsden, but Ramsden knocks her off stride enough that she loses it to Berg. Now Ramsden, she's going to collide, yes. Ramsden bumps into Number 15, Bianca Chikizi. Now it's McNeil. McNeil's going to battle number 11, Blodgett. Penner keeps it in. See if she'll take her space. Tons of room here. Puts it in the middle. Zanetti. Zanetti to Cameron, but it's going to be an offside call. Again, less than 2 minutes unofficially. There shouldn't be too much time added on here in the first half. Not many stoppages, if any. So we're getting late here in the first half. Again, we're tied at one. The visiting Dalhousie Tigers and the St. FX X-Women on this X-Varsity Club webcast of X-Women Soccer. The home opener for the X-Women. A great crowd here at Oland Stadium. Thanks for joining us. It's Corey LeBlanc along with Marcy Kennedy. If you're just joining us, Dal opened the scoring at about the 33-minute mark. An errant or a ball went through the hands of Maris Miller on a cross. And there's a left-footed shot. Miller makes the save on Jakisa. Again, the ball, Marcy, went through Miller's hands and unfortunately bounced in off Victoria Penner, but the X-Women bounced back. That can be a tough one on an own goal. And about a minute or so later, Sarah Cannell, with her first of the season, tied it up at one.
It's definitely been an interesting day for action here on the field.
Now the X-Women in the Tigers' end. Of course, the X-Women in their home white. The Tigers in their traditional black and gold travel uniforms. This is the second match between the teams this season. Last Friday at Wickwire in Halifax on the Dal campus, the Tigers came away with a 3-1 victory. Now it's McNeil. Ramsden.
Back to McNeil.
Now McNeil, taking some of her space, puts it to Venadam. Actually, not Venadam, but Penner. Penner takes a tumble, but she puts it deep into the Tiger zone. McKenna is going to give it a boot. Last couple of minutes here, teams will play it a little bit close to the vest. Don't want to give up a late one. Now it's Venadam puts it through, a little too far for Cameron. And now the Tigers' Penner is after her opponent, and the Tigers clear. It's McNeil. She's going to let it sail through. No, she puts a head on it, but it's right to the foot of Jakisa, and she tries to mount an attack.
Can't get by Ramsden, though.
Ramsden with the left foot. Zanetti. Now the goal scorer, Cannell. We're having the turn number 14, Brock. Was out, and it's going to be a throw in here by Gabby Berg, the second year player. Again, another one of the Calgary Alberta products on the X Women. We're at 45 minutes on the scoreboard clock, but again, we're not the official timekeeper. Only one man has that authority, and it's Wendell McGibbon today, and he hasn't blown it down yet. So it's going to be a throw in for the Tigers here. So early on, Marcy, probably the first 20-25 minutes, a lot of the play in the X-Women zone, and the own goal seemed to culminate that. But once the X-Women get on the scoreboard, they've battled back and got much more of the play in the Tigers' end.
They seem to be controlling the ball a lot more at the end of this half.
McDonald looking for Gooby. Gooby against Berg. This is the combo. Gooby beat Berg on a run to get it across on that own goal. But Dragon comes in to help out, and it'll go out. Actually, we're going to have a corner kick. I thought it might have been off of Gooby. This is a golden opportunity for the Tigers here late in the first half. Off the corner, but Miller comes out.
All over that.
One of the Tigers came roaring in, but couldn't get ahead on it. But Miller, great concentration. She made sure that one didn't get anywhere other than in between her hands and those gloves. And now the Tigers again with possession. McGibbon blows it down. That's the end of the first half. So an entertaining first half, Marcy. Again, we're tied at one goal apiece. An own goal gave the Tigers the lead with at about the 33-minute mark with Sarah Cannell with her first of the season on a great left-footed shot from the top of the box, beating Taryn McKenna. And that's where we're at now, tied at one.
Definitely a lot of action happening here at Oland Stadium today between the Tigers and the X-Women.
So I think we're going to take a little break. Don't go too far away. Maybe go to the fridge or go out to enjoy some sun on the back deck. But stay with us. We'll be back for the second half here at Oland Stadium on the X Varsity Club webcast of X Women Soccer. The X Women won. The Dal Tigers won. welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Oland Stadium in Antigonish, Nova Scotia, for this X-Varsity Club webcast of St. of X X-Women Soccer, featuring the home side, the St. of X X-Women, and the visiting Dal Tigers. And now we have the kickoff to open the second half, the X-Women in control. Again, you're joining us, brought to you by the X-Varsity Club. Hope you're enjoying the match thus far. Tied at one, it's Corey LeBlanc here, along with Marcy Kennedy. Marcy, McKenna, the goal kick. It's all the way to Jaquiza. Jaquiza's been dangerous throughout the match.
She's definitely been a crucial player for the Tigers throughout this game.
Santilli puts the body in the number 14, Alex Brotch. Now Venedam, even though she got grabbed by the jersey, gets away with it. Tries to get it to Cameron, but that gets chipped away. And we're going to have a corner kick here. That went off of Vanderland. So the first corner kick of the match for the X-Women, looking to unbreak this 1-1 tie. So what can we look for here, Marcy? Dragon's going to take it.
And McKenna has some good positioning in the net right now. They're definitely fighting for position inside the 18-yard box.
Dragon gets a foot on it, but it's cleared away quite easily by Wallace with the head. Now Dow trying to head the other way, but Penner knocks Gooby off the ball. Ramsden, it's off Ramsden. Looking now, it's Miller in a foot race.
And that was all Maris Miller.
Miller makes a great play to beat the speedy Gooby to the ball and clear it up.
Zanetti now, turning it around.
Now it's Venedam. Trevor Reddick doesn't look too happy with the call on the sideline that went off Venedam. Now Venedam puts the big boot, but the ball wasn't there.
And Sarah Kennell just couldn't get enough behind that one.
Rush gets a foot on it, but it's right to McKenna on the hop. About 10 minutes into the second half, things have settled in here again. Dow with the early start, the own goal to take the lead about 33 minutes in. And then less than a minute later, the X-Women knotted up on the first goal of the season from Sarah Cannell. And that's where we stand here in the second half. And really, since both those goals, things have been pretty even on both sides. Lauren Landry back in for the Tigers. Now in the throw-in, Willicks. And it bounces. And McNeil gets a foot on, although she's being hounded by Ashley Donnelly.
Now the X-Women must have had some talk in the dressing room because they seem to have come in a lot stronger this half.
Now on a bouncing ball, McNeil gets called a little too aggressive there against Donnelly. So here are the Tigers from about 30 yards. It's going to be Blodgett. Everyone jockeying for position here. Miller bouncing around on her goal line. Ball comes in. It is hit. Tigers put it in, but harmlessly to Miller, who gives it a bounce. Miller again, the third-year keeper from St. John's, taking over full-time duties. Actually, she had quite a bit of action last year with the injuries to Anna Thompson. And really near the end of the year became the starter for the X-Women and now assumes the role for a full season.
And that was a great send-off to midfield by Maris Miller there.
Again, a lot of play at the midfield here. It's Dragon hounding her Dal opponent.
And there's lots of contact happening in this game too.
One thing, it's been, as you said, a lot of contact, but consistent by Wendell McGibbon, the referee. Fair on both sides, and now I think once you get to into a match so far, they know what can and can't get by him. So as long as it's consistent and down the middle, I think the players are happy with it.
We're definitely getting a competitive game here.
Miller puts a little fake on with Gooby hounding her. Miller puts a toe on it. Dragon can't control. Now she puts the chase on against Andy Vanderland. Along the sideline gets knocked out. Vanderland with the quick throw in. Now it's Brush. And now there's Brush again. Venedam. Venedam with that left foot. Tries to make a run, cuts it back in. Great defense there. Finally comes loose. Venetem double teamed. But Venetem still working hard. Gets her foot on it. Tried to get Zanetti a little too far for her.
X-Women keeping it in Tiger territory here.
There's the call right in front of Wendell McGibbon. A little wave off there by the X-Women. Looks like number 10. Yes, it was Cannell, the goal scorer for the X-Women. Didn't agree with that call. But now it's the Tigers back. But it ends up with Zanetti, who's tripped up.
And she's out.
Now the X-Women will have a chance to set things up. Now it's Ramsden.
And as we said earlier, she has great control over the game.
She's definitely one of the leaders out there for the X-Women. Keeps everything stable. She puts an egg canal, gets a head on it, but now Trevor Reddick's up at his seat off the bench, imploring Penner to squeeze in here on the play, push things up. So Reddick looking, and the veteran coach in his 10th season, trying to get some offense going here for the X-Men. Penner with a good throw in. Cameron comes floating in, gets her body on it, and now it's the Venedam. She left foots it in, but the Tigers clear. Now Venedem lets it sail, and it's going to be, no, it goes to the Tigers. Venedem thought it was going to be a throw-in for the X-Women and let it go, and now Penner knocks it out. So the Tigers.
Slowly moving up the field, one throw-in after another.
A little bit of room here for the Tigers. It's Blodgett. Blodgett tries to put it ahead to Rick. To Jakisa. That didn't work. And we have a whistle, and the X-Women now will take over. So again, just a reminder, the home opener for the X-Women here, the first varsity match of the regular season on the turf here at Oland Stadium. This is just the opener of a doubleheader tonight. We'll see the men in action, the Tigers and the X-Men, after this one. So it'll be at least partly under the lights here at Oland Stadium. But a great night for soccer, certainly, Marcy. The weather, nice and warm, great for the fans, great for the players. The wind is really a non-factor. I wouldn't even call them gusts here and there, but certainly a great night for soccer.
Definitely a beautiful day at Oland Stadium.
Now Cameron in pursuit.
McKenna's on top of it, though.
But McGregor Bales calmly puts a head on it to her keeper. As you said, McKenna coolly corralled it. And now it's Venedem. She can't get it. Here comes Santilli. We haven't called her name in a little while. She had a strong first half. A little more quiet here in the second. Has been on her foot too much. Again, a lot of it because the X-Women have had a lot of the play in the Tigers' end. Good defensive play there by Berg. Now it's Blodgett. Blodgett tried to hit a streaking Landry, but that didn't work. And it's cleared out by Penner. So the X-Women, a few of them with the hands on the hips, trying to catch their breath a little bit here. The action's been back and forth here in the second half. Fatigue might start to be a factor, certainly, as we move along here.
Definitely. I mean, a lot of these girls have been playing the entire game.
Laura Woodman makes her first appearance of the match, the second-year striker from Halifax. Of course, played with Halifax Dumbrack this summer. And now Emma Landry back in.
And Landry has been a really strong player for the Tigers in this game.
Number 9. So again, Woodman for the X-Women, who had a strong rookie season for St. FX last year up front. She makes her first appearance, so it should be some nice fresh legs and see if we can get her freed up here on the offensive end. Now Ramsden takes a little tumble. Her shoelace came loose. Now she's ready to roll. Unofficially about 62 minutes into the match here. Scoreless second half thus far. About 17 minutes in, we had one goal apiece in the first half. About 33 minutes in, a goal The ball goes through Maris Miller's hands and off Victoria Penner, but less than a minute later, Sarah Cannell nodded it for the X-Women, and that's where we stand now, approaching just about midway through the second half. Penner clears it there, so we're going to have a, looks like a corner for the Tigers, so this is certainly a golden opportunity, Marcy, for the Tigers to break the tie.
For sure, and it definitely tests Merrill Miller in nets here. Corner kicks are crucial for goalies.
What's the key for the keeper on this, Marcy? Is just to, well, both get her teammates set up, but be aggressive to the ball?
The trick is to be on the far end of the net away from the kicker so then you can run towards the ball as opposed to back for it. And as you can see, Maris Miller, she's already on top of that.
Yeah, it's certainly easier to backpedal or to go forward than to try to start the backpedal with bodies behind you. And like you said, Miller proved it there. She was on her far post, and she didn't have to move too far.
Miller has definitely mastered her angles after her 3 years here at St. Evax.
So now Zanetti's going to take a break.
Stepping on the field for the
Mary McDonald.
Mary McDonald.
Mary McDonald, a rookie from Kingston, Ontario. So a couple of fresh players up front in for the X-Women. There's Woodman. Woodman, who just came in maybe about 5 minutes ago. Second-year player.
And, I mean, you can just see the competitiveness between the players here on the field.
Both teams.
Very competitive, very aggressive. You can tell they really both want this win.
And as we've said all along, a very physical game would certainly, along with the speed of it, can be very draining. Wendell McGibbon letting the teams play, and now
Stephanie Cameron there with the touch.
She had some more room, but tried to put it off, and it got blocked. Looked like she had some more space to take, but thought she had a ball she could put through to a teammate. Now it's Ramsden. Ramsden making a little run with the give and go. Ramsden! And again, no call from McGibbon. It looked like a incidental contact, physical, but the Tigers player, looks like Santilli, went down heavily. It looks like she got the hit up near the neck or head area. But again, Ramsden's been physical this afternoon.
No, and it appears to be Megan Wilcox who was down for the Dalhousie Tigers.
Actually Wilcox, she's up, she's okay. So
tough hit.
The Oland Stadium crowd gives a hand to the Tiger back. But
and
again,
I mean, the crowd is just great today. They're all out here supporting the X-Women teams. We have a drop happening at the midfield right now.
Which you don't see. I don't know, I've been doing these webcasts for 4 or 5 years now, X-Men, I think that's the first time I've seen a drop ball in a game. That's it, Cannell looking for the call, and she gets it from McGibbon. Now it'll be McNeil getting some instruction from Rams and seeing what they're going to do. So McNeil backs off, looks like she's going to take the kick.
One of my fellow Birkhouse alum, Nicole McNeil.
Of course, has been a valuable player for the X-Men, McNeil, and in her fourth year from neighboring New Glasgow. So hello to all her friends who couldn't make it down the soon-to-be fully twinned highway to see the X-Women tonight, watching from Pictou County.
And I mean, the veterans for the X-Women are playing a huge role today. Nicole McNeil, Megan Ransden, Zanetti, Cameron, they're doing a great job on the field, putting lots of pressure on the Tigers.
And now it's Landry with the loose ball, trying on the give and go, but broken up by Cannell. And there's Dragon, and she's knocked off the ball, but it will be an X throw-in. And it's Gabby Berg going to do the honors. 67 minutes in unofficially. Again, we're tied at one here at Oland Stadium, the home opener for the X-Women. Thanks for joining us on this X-Varsity Club webcast. I'm Corey LeBlanc along with Marcy Kennedy.
And of course, this is brought to you by the X-Varsity Club. Join the team behind the teams.
Ramsden puts a big boot. It's off a Tiger, off another Tiger, and now McNeil closes in on her opponent. There's a ball through. Penner's going to have to put chase on, but it does. Oh, no. No, it looked like it was kept in, but then the lines person, Shauna Poirier, saw that it did go out and Landry couldn't keep it in, so X will have a throw in.
And fans, make sure to stay in touch with St. of X Athletic throughout the season. Become a fan on our Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter for the latest scores and news. You can also visit www.goxgo to sign up for our weekly newsletter or receive instant text messages on all your X-Men and X-Women team news.
Now on the throw-in. Penner goes along the sideline. Cameron goes up for it, but Venedan's able to use that all of that 5-10 frame to keep it in along the sideline. And the X-Women control, Woodman, who again brought in some fresh legs here early in the second half.
Now Sarah Cannell.
Trying to corral it. There's Dragon. Dragon battling. And she's called for the infraction, and Dow will take over. Tara McKenna with some instruction. Looks like she's going to take the boot. Ramsden zoning in, and McNeil. McNeil battling her opponents, number 9, Emma Landry. Trickles in, Ramsden now shielding, and Miller comes sliding out to corral it. So smart play even there by Ramsden, the shield off the Dal attacker so Miller could dive and cover up the ball. Dal with the Gillingham goal here, Santilli along with Wallace. Back to Santilli. Santilli, she's dragged down by Cannell. Now Santilli with the quick drop. Puts it back to Wilcox. On the far side, Dragon, she's harassed. Stolen by Landry. Landry with the left foot. Miller comes out for it. Oh.
Quick tip, but she got it.
Took a high bounce, but Miller skied to get a hand on it and then corral it. And now she puts it to the far side. It's going to not exactly what she would have wanted there. It was out to touch for a Dal throw in. So again, these two rivals battle to a 3-1. Tigers win here to start the season last Friday. Now, go ahead, Marcy.
We have a St. of X possession. Megan Ramsden taking the ball. And as we said earlier, she's really great at controlling the field. She's definitely the player you want doing those kicks.
McGregor Bales takes the kick and puts it ahead. McNeil
getting
with
lots
a nifty
of pressure.
Move. She gets banged there. And she goes down, so the call made by McDibbin. So, and again, as you said, McNeil, the fourth-year veteran from New Glasgow, having a solid match on the back end for the X-Women. And now again, Ramsden. Vanadam can't get it. Tigers looking to go on the attack. And it will go to the X-Women. Landry thought might stay in their possession, but it was off her. And now Penner. Venedam.
That was a nice throw to Venedam. Oh, she couldn't keep it in.
Now it will be off Landry. So Venedam looks like she'll take the throw in, or probably will go to Penner again. No, it will be Venedam. Woodman couldn't corral it, but it comes all the way through to McDonald, but she's bodied by number 2, Samantha McDonald, who made a strong play, and McKenna was able to scoop it up. McNeil again. Ramsden. She tries to chip it over off in midair from Landry, and then she takes Landry down and puts it to Penner. Now Santilli with the left foot. Gingerly puts it in, but it rolls to Miller. Now Miller sizes things up. No Not to put words in Trevor Reddick's mouth, but he must be more pleased, at least to this point, with the effort, especially on the scoring chance end of it. I know Dal had several quality chances in the opening match last week. The X-Men, women rather, have been certainly more responsible on the defensive end today. Now Venedem closes in on Santilli. Battling Ramsden. Again, Ramsden just not afraid of the physical battles, and she wins most of them. Tigers gets a shot away. Miller.
Great catch by Miller.
Makes it look easy. Didn't see what Tiger got a foot on it there, and sometimes that's worth a chance. You might catch the keeper off guard. She was well covered and got a good shot away, but Miller was prepared. Landry looks to settle against Woodman. Now it's Blodgett. Chiquisa puts it ahead. Now it's Gooby. Gooby can't control it, and it goes out for a goal kick.
That'll be Miller's kick.
Unofficially about 74 minutes into the home opener for the X-Men. They're tied with the Tigers at one. You're enjoying this webcast brought to you by the X-Varsity Club.
And of course, feel free to send us feedback on the broadcast. We welcome any comments or messages. We can receive your emails at the following address, stfx.webcast@gmail.com. So be sure to send us all your thoughts on our broadcast. We'd really appreciate it.
Good or bad, right?
I don't know about that.
Well, we won't call them bad. We'll call them constructive criticism. We're always looking for that.
Always looking to improve, right, Corey?
Exactly. And now McDonald battling McDonald. It's the battle of the Macs. And it comes away. Now McDonald gets a piece of it, but she can't control it. And now Samantha McDonald lets it roll out.
That'll be McKenna's ball.
Going to have substitution here for the Tigers. Looks like Chiquisa returning. It is. She's in for Lauren Landry. Chiquisa's had a strong game, so she should have some fresh legs here for the home stretch the last 15 minutes or so. Calling the handball there on the X-Men, so Dal takes over. And there's Chiquisa, who just came back into the game, and she had a step on Penner, but the ball rolled out for an X-Women throw-in. Again, just a reminder, this is the opening half of a doubleheader webcast. Coming up, the X-Men, who defeated the Dal Tigers 1-0 last Friday night. They'll have the rematch here at Oland Stadium, and more than likely for the bulk of it under the lights here on a great night here in Antigonish. So hope you can stay with us if you can't make it out to the stadium. And again, we certainly would like some thoughts and advice and some hellos from friends and family. Let us know. Drop us an email. And now it's Woodman. She puts a heavy foot on the ball. Eventually comes to Cameron. McDonald's bodied. It's going to come to Dragon. Dragon puts it back to Brooke. Nicole McNeil with some space. Goes with the left foot. Sails over Penner, and it's going to go out to touch. With a hard battle like this, Marcy, you're almost getting to the time of the match that it might be some fatigue may set in, a bounce or two, because the teams are battling pretty evenly here, especially in the second half.
These girls are definitely playing hard. I'm sure they're feeling it at this point in the game.
Now McDonald putting some pressure again on McDonald. Cameron can't come up with it. Penner comes in aggressively on Chiquisa, and she gets the call against her. That was a tough one for Penner. You can't fault the effort by Penner, and Trevor Reddick raises his hands. He doesn't understand the call on that one. I don't think he's going to get a change, certainly at this point, so Dal's going to have a kick here. here's the boot to the top of the box. Some jockeying there for position. The X-Men are able to clear it. Looked like Woodman off the head. Now it's Cannell. Cannell grabs her opponent and throws her down. Blodgett. But Gibbon is right there to make the call. So now this is from a dangerous area for the Tigers, Marcy. A golden opportunity here to get a scoring chance on Miller.
It'll definitely be interesting to see who pulls through in the end to take this game. The girls are all fighting hard here on the field. It's a great game to watch.
As we get down to 10, 12 minutes, you see the members of both the X-Men and the Tigers in both end zones getting warmed up for their match coming up after this one.
We definitely have a night of excitement here ahead of us at Oland Stadium.
We certainly have plenty of time and lots to settle here in this match as McGibbon sets up both sides for this kick. It's going to be Santilli. She tees it up. It's off the wall. It comes loose. Another great defensive effort there by the X-Women on a couple of those.
And their defense has been very strong this half.
Woodman settles it, battling Jakisa. Now it's Penner. Penner against number 11, Blodgett.
Over to Cannell, but it didn't make it.
Now Santilli with some space. Oh, chipped ahead by Rams, and she got caught. Here's Emma Landry in alone. She's all down. And we're going to see a penalty kick, I do believe. As Emma Landry drove through, and Nicole McNeil really had no choice, had to haul her down. But again, that was a great effort by the Tigers, showing some nifty moves, and eventually getting through there was Emma Landry. And now Miller, with her test of the match, it looks like Joanna Blodgett will take it. Miller in the crouch, waiting for the signal. And there it is, and it's a goal. A beautiful shot there by Blodgett, giving the Tigers a 2-1 lead. So, as we said, that opportunity came up. And certainly the penalty kicks anything can happen. And a great shot there by Joanna Blodgett.
Dalhousie taking the lead. I mean, that was a very difficult position for Maris Miller to be in. Very tough position for a goalie. She did great, though, and I'm sure she'll get them the next time.
And certainly no dispute on the call led to the penalty kick. McNeil got beaten, and the natural reaction, it was going to be in alone for Landry. She grabbed her and hauled her down.
And I mean, in most sports, that's when the fouls happen, when people get beat.
Yeah. So now the X-Men see if they can bounce back as they did in the first half after giving up a goal and come back with the answer. Cameron loses it. So again, about the 80th minute on the penalty kick, it's Blodgett. And now it's Gooby. Gooby, and she loses it out of bounds against the pressure of Dragon. So the X-Women now with about 10 minutes more or less, depending on the injury time, to knot this score up, see what they can do here against the Tigers.
Sarah Kennell with the ball. Quick turnover.
That's chipped out. Looked like might have been off an X-Woman, but it wasn't. So we'll have Gabby Berg, and now we're going to have a substitution. Looks like Melanie Sonata is going to make her first appearance, the third-year player from Calgary. So again, Reddick looking for some fresh legs, maybe now to make the push to knot this score before time runs out. Now it's Jakisa with a nifty move on Benedem. Jakisa with the left foot for looking for Santilli. But that's broken up by Woodman. McNeil. She puts a heavy foot on it. Changes the feel, but it comes to the Tigers. Now some space for the Tigers. Trying to put it in, but it's knocked down by Woodman. And Benedem. Benedem has some space. Benedem puts some foot on it, but then it's knocked down by Daphne Wallace, who's had a great game in the middle. Now Benedem. Ramsden with the left foot. Now a battle for the ball there between McDonald and McGregor Bales. Comes free. Wallace back to McGregor Bales. Battle there now to between Berg. Here come the Tigers again. And there's a battle, and that's an easy call there, the foul on Emma Landry.
It's going to be X women's ball at the half.
As Gabby Berg is knocked down. We're going to have a couple of subs, as we said. It looks like Lauren Landry will come back in for the Tigers. And with her first appearance in the match, Melanie Sonata. Looks like she's coming in for Cameron, I believe. Cameron looks a little gimpy as she heads to the bench. So that's not good news for the X-women. Stephanie Cameron looks a little gimpy.
She's definitely a crucial striker to the team.
Now Landry can't keep it in. There's an opportunity for the X-women. Quick throw in Penner. Venadin. Venadin can't control. So now Dal again, looking to turn it upfield. Landry gets knocked down. It's going to be off her, though. No call, no infraction, just out of bounds. Oh, actually, it was a call on a foul. Dal will take over. McGregor Bales. Puts the right foot on it. Getting up there is Penner. Comes to the middle of the fresh leg at Sonata. Cannell. That's a little far, although McDonald's in pursuit against two defenders, and it comes back to Samantha McDonald of the Tigers. And now Dragon with a nice play to gain control, but she can't keep it in. Great effort by Rachel Dragon. And now McKenna will take a kick for the Tigers. Time running short here for the X-Men. Unofficially about 5 minutes left until the 90th minute. And then, of course, depending on the time, Wendell McGibbon decides to put on his watch. Tigers lead here 2-1. Al Miller is going to be an offside call there as Gooby breaks in. But Miller was nice and aggressive coming out there against Gooby.
And, I mean, that's a tough call for a goalie to make about when to come out of their net like that.
Now Ramsden, the general, certainly of the X-Men on the back line, if not on the whole field, keeps everything running for the team. And now it's Penner. Penner having trouble with it. Skying there, Woodman, but she's beaten on the ball by Blodgett, who's given the Tigers a 2-1 lead here in the second half on a penalty kick. Now it's Brush. Or Berg, rather. I'm sorry, not Brush. Now it goes out of bounds off of Joanna Blodgett. So again, 1-1 after the first half. 33 minutes in, an own goal gave the Tigers the lead. Less than a minute later, Sarah Cannell with a great left-footed low kick beat Tara McKenna. And now here in the second half, a penalty kick by Joanna Blodgett has given the Tigers a 2-1 advantage. So it's all about getting some pressure now, Marcy, for the X-Men. When you're trailing 2-1, you have to start taking a few more chances.
I mean, the X-Men have had a really strong defense this whole half. They just need to step it up in their offense.
And now off the corner, this is a big moment. The X-Men certainly can't give up any more goals here at this juncture. And it does come, a header there, but it's deflected wide. I don't know if that was Jenna Gooby or Blodgett. I believe it was Blodgett again, who again is the goal scorer here in the second half. And now Miller, Maris Miller, who's had to make three or four top-notch saves for the X-Women. Certainly been the more tested of the two keepers this evening. Now Ramsden again in a physical battle, and Ramsden, she gets the benefit of the call, and I think it was a good one. She was hauled down.
Yeah, you could see her jersey coming off there.
Yes. Landry, it was a good battle, but certainly the right call. Landry held on to the jersey as they both went down. And now the X-Men again have to start heading the other way in their usual home white with blue against the Tigers, if you're just tuning in their row black and gold. The Tigers, the defending AUS champions, looking up their record to 2-0.
Great touch by Megan Ramsden.
Now it's McDonald, the second half sub for Trevor Reddick, the freshman from Kingston, Ontario. Now the Tigers certainly not going to take any chances with a one-goal lead here late. They don't want to give anything up to the X-Women. Close quarters there in the far side, and finally trickles out for an X-Women throw-in. And now Trevor Reddick, another substitution. Brianna Cozzolino making her first appearance.
And of course, this broadcast is brought to you by the X Varsity Club. Join the team behind the teams. The X Varsity Club is a fundraising entity for the St. of X Athletic Program. Your financial support is essential to our success in maintaining the tradition of excellence. Visit www.goxgo.ca for more information.
There comes Nicole McNeil off, replaced by Cozzolino. Great effort by McNeil. And back in for the Tigers, number 10, actually making her first appearance, Ashley Donnelly. Now, Cannell, the X-Women goal scorer in the middle. Can't get at the Penner. That's broken up by Landry. Now going the other way, Sonata. Had the idea to hit Venedem. That didn't work. And now it's Cozzolino who just checked in. Venedem. And that heads out of bounds. Venedem on the throw-in. Sonata. She can't get it. Now Venedem against number 11, Joanna Blodgett. Again, who has the lead goal here in the second half. Cozzolino. Ooh. Oh, Cozzolino and Penner collide. They both look okay as they bounce back up. Ball heads out. Dragon can't keep it in bounds. Now Lauren Landry with the throw-in. She goes to Blodgett. Blodgett, who has had a strong game from start to finish for the Tigers. One of their top players, an AUS All-Star last season. Again, about 15 seconds from 90 minutes on the game clock here at Oland Stadium. Not sure how much time we have left officially. And there's a shot. Oh, a dangerous one there by Woodman. And it hit the crossbar of the football stanchion. So Mercy there, a dangerous, and it seemed to catch McKenna off guard. A great strike.
Very close. And had it just been a few feet lower, probably would have been in.
Penner gets bodied by Landry. The smaller Landry going up against Victoria Penner certainly held her own. Now it's Ramsden. Cannell. Cannell can't control. Now Landry. Ramsden with the left foot. Coming over is McDonald trying to corral it. Now Sonata. Sonata can't control. Comes to Santilli. Again, the Tigers keep the control. Cannell. Cannell with a dipsy doodle, but she loses it to number 14, Wallace. Now up the far sideline, Cozzolino against Landry, but Ramson's there to protect and clear. Sonata can't control it. Now she does. Puts it ahead to McDonald. X-Women here down to the nitty-gritty, but can't get any pressure here as Cozzolino puts it back to Miller. Miller puts it to the middle, but right to a Tiger, and now comes back to Miller. She has to sky for it, and it's going to be an offside call regardless. Again, we're at 90 minutes on the score clock, late here in the match. The Tigers lead the X-Women 2-1. Ramsden, a low laser to Sonata. Sonata can't control. Right back to Ramsden. She skies one now. Dragon can't get at it. It's going to sail out, but the Tigers keep it in. And now the X-Men are going to leave a trickle out for a throw-in. Actually, the Tigers are going to have a throw-in here late. Now the battle on the far side, Cozzolino. And it will go over to the X-Men now, who have to get up the field.
And now we have 90 minutes on our clock here at Oland Stadium. Of course, we have to wait for the official to call it.
X-Women heading the wrong way. Now it's Miller. She's going to have to put a big boot on it, I think, to at least get it up the field and give the X-Women a chance to make some hay at the other end against McKinnon, try to knot this score. Sonata skying over here is Wallace, who's had a solid game in the middle for the Tigers, especially up in the air. Now it's Woodman. Woodman against Landry. Woodman, Cannell. She loses it to Landry. Number 9, Emma Landry. Emma and Leah Landry. And the whistle blows, and that's the end of the match. The Dalhousie Tigers up their record to 2-0 with back-to-back wins over the Sainte-Evex X-Women. One second-half goal on the penalty kick by Joanna Blodgett was the margin of victory. A really competitive and physical match, Marcy.
It was definitely a great game to watch here. And, of course, there's another great game happening shortly, the men's soccer game. And Corey and I will be broadcasting it all to you here.
So, again, just to wrap it up, the X-Women drop to 0-2 on the season, a 2-1 loss here in their home opener at Oland Stadium. And as we're watching the teams greet each other and get ready to shake up, I noticed that Stephanie Cameron, whether it's just a cramp, hopefully, or a muscle, but she looks a little lame as she heads to shake hands with the other team, so hopefully that's not too serious. Cameron had a strong match for them.
So, and of course, we have Stu McNeil on the field right now. He's going to try and grab a player to have a little interview here. He'll be joining us shortly.
And just while we're waiting for Stu, and he'll give us the thumbs up. Just to recap the scoring, the Tigers opened it on an own goal about 33 minutes in. A ball slipped through the hands of Maris Miller on a cross. It ended up deflecting in off of Victoria Penner. That gave the Tigers a 1-0 lead. But less than a minute later, the X-Women showed some resolve, bouncing back quickly. Sarah Cannell finished the nifty passing play that was started by Penner and deposited with her left foot low to the right side of Tara McKenna. And that was the scoring until about the 80th minute, when on a penalty kick, Joanna Blodgett gave the margin of victory to the Tigers.
And I believe Stu's out there with Sarah Cannell right now for an interview.
I mean, we are going to head down to Stu McNeil at field level with the goal scorer for the X-Women, Sarah Cannell.
Hi, this is Stu McNeil. I'm here at the Oland Stadium in beautiful Antigonish, Nova Scotia. I'm here joined with Sarah Cannell, player of the game for Sainte-Evex X-Women soccer. And we just had a tough loss to Dalhousie, 2-1. Although it was a tough loss, there was many positives you girls did today. You want to explain that a little bit, Sarah?
Yeah, very strong. We've been working on keeping possession and working our way up through the sides and trying to work on using our outlets on the wings. And we really came out strong today and focused on that. And we had a lot of positive plays and a lot of plays for it that were showing a lot of improvement from last game.
You girls had a pretty tough physical game and pretty physically demanding. There's a few bodies thrown around there. How did that fare for all the girls?
Yeah, definitely a bit frustrating. I know we kept our heads up, stayed positive. We were working hard on communicating throughout the field. Some tough calls were made and some were
questionable.
A bit questionable, not to throw anything around. But it was a pretty physical game, but it'll only make us stronger in the end. Yeah.
Well, thank you very much, Sarah, and good luck in the rest of your season. Thank you. This is Stu McNeil from Oland Stadium.
Thanks a lot, Stu. And again, that was with Sarah Cannell, the goal scorer for the X-Women here tonight in a 2-1 loss to the Dalhousie Tigers. Again, with the loss, the X-Women drop to an early season 0-2. The Dalhousie Tigers, the defending conference champions, improved to 2-0. So again, the final score here from Oland Stadium, the Dalhousie Tigers 2, the Sainte-Evex X-Women 1. Thanks for joining us on this X-Varsity Club webcast. I'm Corey LeBlanc for Marcy Kennedy. Thank you, and join us in a few minutes for the Tigers and the X-Men.